reviews. We have online today very interesting reviews. There's one review which may not be there, like Naresh. Under Naresh, there is one review where he was supposed to do Panchatantra. Unfortunately, his father expired and he may not be able to give the review. But we do have something else coming up in that slot. We'll start with The Remains of the Day by Kazuo Ishiguro. This is done by Navnath. Please promote it.
Hello everyone. Today I am going to review the book The Remains of the Day by author Kazuo Ishiguro. Kazuo Ishiguro is a Japanese born British author. He born in Nagasaki, Japan. And his parents moved to UK when he was 5 years old. He is a very renowned British author. In 2018 he got a Nobel Prize in Literature. His book, The Remains of the Day, got Booker Prize in 1989. So it is very high octane his work in the case of fiction. Talking about the plot of this book, this is a book that you can say it is an example of how to waste your life. The Remains of the Day is a story of a butler. As you may know, you know what butler is. You have read the P.G. Woodhouse literature that Jeeves is a butler. So butler is a part of typical British society. And this is the story, it's the life story of a butler. And he is giving, he's recollecting his life as a butler. The story starts in 1956, post World War II. After World War II, Stevens spent his life as a butler in a Darlington pub. He served there for around 40 plus years. And after World War II, his owner, Lord Darlington, he has to, he died due to. He was a Nazi sympathizer, so he has a very death. After the death of Lord Darlington, the palace was owned by an American owner, Mr. Faraday. And Mr. Faraday asked Stevens to go on a trip because he has spent around 40 years in that palace and he was a butler and chief of staff at the palace. So his new owner, who is very friendly, he asked him to go on a trip. So, Stevens looked forward for a motoring trip across Britain with his owner's fold. And this book is about his journey during those 7 days, and he recollects his life, that how he lived his life during these years. So, there are only few characters in this book. Stevens as a butler, then his father is also a butler. And, then there is a Miss Kenton. Miss Kenton is a staff at Lord Darlington. Then there is Mr. Faraday, his new owner. Lord Darlington said he was a Nazi sympathizer. He has a very serious, closet character. And so these are the only characters, and there are only few characters that Stevens recollects. So the literature style of this book is like a flashback. So, Kazuo Ishiguro has used memories as a powerful tool to explain this, to narrate this. Because you can play with the memories. So, at one point you can recollect how it was 20 years back, at a certain point you can say how it was 2-3 days back. So, he has used memories as a powerful tool and he has shown us so many memories through this book at various incidents. Then, Stevens started his career at the Lord Darlington as a footman. Then he slowly becomes also a chief of staff at the Darlington House. And throughout this book, he highlights the concept called dignity, how to live life in a dignified way. But if you consider the life of butler, there's nothing much to tell, there's nothing much to, because the portrayal of the Stevens character, the Kazuo Ishiguro has done in such a way that Stevens has no feelings about anything. He is only concerned about his duties as a butler. So there is a Miss Kenton character there, and she is in deeply in love with Stevens. Stevens is also in love with her, but they can't express their feelings. So after, at the age of 16, when he recollects his life, he thinks about the feelings he has never shared with anyone, and what kind of life he has lived. Then on his boarding trip, he recollects how the World War shaped England, and how that World War shaped his profession also. In this book, he has shared some experience about how he only considered his duty as a priority, and he has never expressed his feeling in his life. There's a one incident in which his father, Mr. William Stevens, he's also a butler, and he was on his deathbed, some around the house in somewhere, he was on his deathbed, and he still had to serve cocktails to the guests. And he was in a dilemma of what to do, whether to go to meet his father who is taking last breath, and or whether to serve cocktails to guests. So he is in a dilemma. So there are so many incidents where he overshadowed or he overempowered his feelings and just did his work as a butler. After, in the end of this book, he finally met Miss Kenton, and Miss Kenton had around him, he asked her whether she can rejoin as a staff on the Darlington Hall, because they are short of staff now. Because the situation had changed in the war, people no longer afford butlers and people. But she says she cannot do that now because she is not settled in her life, she has grandchildren. So at this point of time, Stevens recollect that how he has not expressed his feeling and what kind of wasted life he lived. So that's about the plot, and why you should read this book, The Remains of the Day. Why should you read this? Though it's a story of a butler, there are typical political and sociological undertones that written by Kazuo Ishiguro. So many times in a lecture that Kazuo Ishiguro gave you a Nobel Prize, he wrote that when he thought about Stevens' character, he actually says that he wants to say that he, in a sense, we also live like Stevens, because we think it's about some big corporation or big nation. We do our jobs, but we don't know exactly what impact that has. And sometimes small things in life will miss you. Because we think that our job is important, but also our life is also important, and that's what we have to express our feelings. So that's about the remains of the day. Thank you. Okay. The style is a narration, like the entire book is narration by Stevens. He is narrating his life, like it happened last day, it happened few years back. It's like, yeah, it's a narration. But first few pages, it's very difficult to understand why, because he's referring as a third person. Therefore, it's very difficult what he wants to say. But after a few pages, it's very gripping. And at certain points, you can't read further, because at that point, he's cold-hearted, regarding himself also. So at the end of the book, you feel like you have really lost a friend, so that you want to hug that Stevens, that why you do it, why, what happens you want to, you should express yourself. So that is the feeling at the end of this book. So for a few pages, it's very difficult, because it's typical English environment. It happens with PG in the house also. We don't know what Jeeves wants to say, and his typical accent. The same happens here, even the Stevens, the language he uses is a typical English language, a standard English language, and he, you know, divert from his language an entire book. So it's like a standard butler language he has used in his book.